Hey, what's up everyone? Today we're going to see how to fetch API using React. I'm going to create a new project here with npx create React app, name is characters. So this will be the folder name. So I'm going to hit enter and it will install all the necessary packages and create a new project for the React. So I'm going to show you what API we are going to use here. So this is the endpoint we are going to use. So the API name is the Breaking Bad API. It will be show some characters like you can see this is the ID name, birthday, occupation, image, nickname, and we'll also use Bootstrap CDN for this. So it will take some time. Maybe okay, it has been successfully installed all of the packages for the React. So we are going to change the directory using cd charctrs characters, and we are now in characters folder. Here is the characters folder. So I'm going to also install another package named React Spinners. So in this case we are going to use like for the loading. So when it will be loading, till this time we are getting the data from the API, it will be just load. So yarn add, it will show as a spinner that data is being loaded, and then React spinners, yarn add React spinners. Okay, so and then we are going to clean up some files from here. So we don't need app.css, app taste, and then logo svg, report, and setup test.js. So I'm going to delete these files from here. And also from here, we don't need this, and we need to remove this, and we'll have a fresh, just a simple div with h1 tag. So we can say h1, and then we can say here heading or maybe welcome. Okay, so it is being installed, so it will take some time maybe, and then I have to save, and by this time I need to go here and remove this web vitals from here, as long as we don't need this, and we already deleted these files. And then I'm going to save here and come back here, and then I'm going to just make it as an arrow function. So you see this is just a simple app. Okay, so now I'm going to just start with npm start or yarn start. You can see this is the heading. Okay, so I'm going to copy it from here and paste it in public and index.html. We don't need these comments, and I have to remove this and this one too. So I'm going to paste it here. Simply paste it here, and then we can say here that fetch API. This is the title. Okay, and then I'm going to save it, and if you come back here you can see the heading has been changed. So I'm going to now close this on and this on. So I'm going to import use state and use effect from here. So import use state and use effect from React, and then also I will need import bit loader from React spinners from bit loader. Okay, and then we'll create a variable like characters, set characters, and then because the state will be empty array, and another one is for loading and set loading. Use the state false. Okay, and then we are going to make a variable like API URL a constant, and it should be coming from here. So we can say like we can take this the URL main domain and then this characters slash API characters. Okay, and then we are going to use effect here a dependency empty dependency, and then we are going to create a async function array function here. So const load API equal async, and then we are going to say here set loading true, and then call fetch, and then API URL dot then it will return promise, then race, and then race dot json, then we will have data, and set characters we set data here, and then set loading will be false. Sorry, set loading will be false here, and then dot catch here clg console.log here. Okay, and then we have to call this our function here. Okay, so now we can be able to see on console log that this is the data and characters here. Okay, so these characters. So now let's just go to the browser and inspect and console log. You will see that this is how we will get all the data. Okay, so now I have to render the data here. So I'm going to create a components here, name components folder components. So it will be just we want to just loop the data using map functions. So components, and then we say here that character character.js, so single character will show here. Okay, and then I'm going to just const characters characters arrow function, and then return a empty fragment here, and export default character. This one. Okay, and then we don't need anything here for now. I'm going to use the Bootstrap class here, so this will be like class name container, and from top it will be top and bottom it will be margin 5, and then from left and right it will be margin 5. Okay, so you know that how to use Bootstrap container. So I'm going to use dot h1 dot text center, and the title will be characters API. Okay, so you can see it's now showing characters API, and we want to show the loader here if it will be true only. So we are going to see, so loading and then bit loader self closing tag, and then the color will be I'd like to have this color 0096FF, this blue color, and then loading equal loading, and the size will be maybe 22. Okay, so I'm going to reload this, and you see this is being loaded here. Okay, so I'm going to just keep it in a div, and it will be on center. So dot text center, and then paste it here. Okay, now you'll see it's now being loaded. So I'm going to just loop the data, all data here. So let's say like char characters and characters dot map. So it will have data, and then we say char, and then we'll have index, and then we'll return this, and we'll call now this character charact. So character come from components, and then so actually it should be like this. So first bracket will be there, and it should have a key, otherwise it will be error. It will show error on browser console. So key is I, and we will pass as props. So char, and then char. Okay, so now you won't see anything here because we don't have any data on character. So I'm going to just simply get data here as a prop. So char and destructure data here. So char, and you will see clg char, console log char here. So you will see the data. Okay, you'll see object and individual data. So I'm going to now render the data here. So just to remove it, and let me just use a div here. So div class name. So actually, in before that, we have to use a row here actually. So it will be better if we will use a row, otherwise it will be a problem, I think. So we need to have a row here on the container, and then okay, as long as we are going to use column here, so it will be row, and then paste it here. Okay, so in this row we will use this column. So we are going to use this call md3 for the medium screen, call is same 6 for the smaller screen, call xs2 for the extra small screen, and margin top is 3. Okay, and now we are going to call this card, I mean as a class. So we'll use this div, and then image, it will have a alternative text. So we can say char dot what we can say that its name. Okay, and the source will be dynamically show here char. We are using this question marks if it will be undefined. So some of the images maybe it don't have any images. Okay, so image source img. okay, and then we will have class name for this image card img top from the bootstrap class, and we will style it out. So inline style will be width will be 100%, and then height will be 400 pixel. Okay, let's see what images we have. Okay, so you can see that all of the images is showing now. So it's now loading. and then all the data we can see from here. Okay, so you can see some of the images. It don't have an image for this. And now we are going to use a card body class after this image. And then we are going to use this class div title, and then we can see, you can show maybe char dot name. I mean, there should be a dot, so it will show all of the title, I mean this character title. Okay, and then we are going to add more data if you want. So I'm going to show like card takes their status, like char.sta.gs status. So if you want, you can simply it like this sta.gs status, and then you can see it's now showing status is alive or dead, presumed dead. So this is how we can easily fetching all the data from a third party API or from our backend. So I'm going to, you can see it's now responsive to. So this design is pixel 5, you can see it's completely responsive to. We are using just simply Bootstrap using CDN. Okay, so let me know if you have any questions. Thank you so much.